many terrestrial roots that were his Sishya Parampara. Tyagaraja had about 30 direct disciples who learned from him. It is well known that there were three main Sishya Paramparas that arose from Tyagaraja's disciples. The Valajapet school, founded by Valajapet Venkatramana Bhagavatar, the Tillaisthanam school by Tillaisthanam Rama Ayangar, Umayalpuram school by brothers Krishna and Sundara Bhagavatar. Other notable disciples were Manambu Chavadi, Venkata Subbayar, Veena Kuppayar and Subbaraya Shastri. Tyagaraja lived a very simple life, immersed in his devotion to his Lord Rama. So he did not really make any effort to document any of his musical compositions. He would just sing to his Lord Rama and his Sishyas would keep notes. His music and works are alive today through his extensive Sishya Parampara. One of his closest students acted as a major component in bringing his music to us, and his name was Valajapet Venkatramana Bhagavatar. Valajapet Venkatramana Bhagavatar was drawn to Tyagaraja's music at a very young age of 13. He would spend his first 2 years just serving the great guru. One such day, young Venkatramana was setting up for Tyagaraja's daily puja. Tyagaraja would begin his puja every day by singing Tulasi Dalamulache in the Ragam Maya Madhava Gaura. Tyagaraja noticed that young Venkatramana was placing flowers in the same order that would appear in the charanam of the song. This incident was what began young Venkatramana's musical journey. Now, he lived with Tyagaraja for 26 years. And his son, Krishna Swami Bhagavatar, also learned from Tyagaraja. And after Tyagaraja died in 1847, together they spent their entire life writing down his compositions on palm leaves, which are still preserved till today. Another interesting fact about the Sishya Parampara is many of Tyagaraja's Sishyas were actually accomplished musicians even before they came to Tyagaraja. This is a very unique aspect of the Tyagaraja Sishya Parampara as well. Up on the PowerPoint, you see a tree which shows us the extent to which that Tyagaraja has influenced our musical world. We have musical lineages that began under Tyagaraja and they are still around till today. Now, this is only a small fraction of the Sishya Parampara ocean, as I would like to call it. But it gives us an idea of how vast and exhaustive the Sishya Parampara really is. I'm going to give you a couple of examples of famous lineages that have come down to this day. Let us take the example of the Prathama Sishya Manambu Chavadi Venkata Subbayar, who was the guru to the famous Patnam Subramaniayar, who in turn taught Poochi Srinivas Iyengar. Ariyakudi Ramanuja Iyengar was Poochi Srinivas Iyengar's student, and he in turn was K.V. Narayana Swami's and B. Rajamayar's guru. Now this shows us how the Tyagaraja tradition trickles down to our current generation of musicians through the Sishya Parampara. Another well-known example is that of Lalgudi Jayaraman, whose great-grandfather Lalgudi Ramayyar was a direct disciple of Tyagaraja. Now, as a family, they carry on the Tyagaraja Parampara till today. Now, in this tree, it's very interesting to note that we have different types of musicians. We have composers, we have performers, we have singers, we have instrumentalists that carry on the Tyagaraja tradition till today. On that note, we are going to present to you some very unique compositions written by some of these composers of the Tyagaraja Sishya Parampara. Now here is Revati. She is going to give us an idea of what the next part of the program is going to be. Thank you very much for listening to me.